What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. So, as you can see behind me here, I finally got off the passenger side turbo out of the Callaway. It's taken me a few months to eventually get that thing off. It's just been one fight after another, just little obstacles all over the place just to get access to those four bolts that hold it onto the intake. Or excuse me, the exhaust manifold. A lot of struggle, man. This was one reason why I took so much time off, because this one task was just beating me to death. So finally got it off though. So before I take these things over to Rotomasters and have them all dialed in and refurbished, I wanted to just point out some of the differences, because both sides are different. So right off the bat, you can see one of the big differences. This is the driver's side, this is the passenger side. And as you can see, this one has a coupling end on this side, and this side has a bolt-on flange for the tubes that go up to the intercoolers. So this pipe bolts onto here, and then this one has a coupler on it, and it turns up and goes up to the intercooler. It's just kind of interesting. It just, because of the tight packaging in this car, is the reason why they had to do some little differences here and there just to fit the parts into the car, was really challenging. And as I found out, getting those parts out of the car is even more challenging. So other than that, you can see that the back housings are identical. They utilize the same blow-off valves. Just the front housings are the main difference. Now, I picked up some gaskets and these diaphragms for the wastegate. So I'm going to drop these off with the turbos at Rotomasters. And hopefully these things come back relatively quickly. I'm sure that there's going to be some parts that are either hard to find or due to what's going on in the world right now, maybe difficult to come by. But I'm just happy that it's out of the car and I can get these things over there, and I really don't care how long it takes as long as it gets done. The big thing was just getting the turbos out of the car so I could get it over to them. Otherwise, the clock doesn't start until they're sitting over at Rotomasters. So let's go ahead and drop them off. What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. So today we've got a little bit of an update. I know I've been gone for a while. I've had some health things that I've been dealing with. Just been going through a lot lately, but it's kind of time to start getting back into the Corvette and getting some things done on it. I do have a couple of boxes that I've been waiting to open for you guys here, so we're gonna go ahead and do that right now. What do you guys think this is? There's two of them. So here we go. I got the turbos back, and yes, it was a long process. No, I will not tell you how much it cost me. However, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
But if you are interested in having Rotomaster, who is the original guys who did these turbos, they will service and rebuild these old Callaway turbos for you. I did provide to them the gaskets and the diaphragm for the wastegate from Callaway, and they used it during the rebuild. Mine were not particularly too bad. However, the wastegates were in the worst shape. The wastegate housings were so rusted that when they sandblasted them, it just blew holes right through them. So they ended up refabricating this part on both of the turbos for me and reinstalled these placards, the original placards, on here. I'm not sure exactly if they reused some of the original metal. I would imagine they would have, since there's some detail in here, but they definitely fixed them up. Looks great. So when I said that I don't want to tell you guys how much it cost me to have these rebuilt, it's not because it was really expensive. It was because I don't like to disclose pricing for services from companies, because you know, that's their business. If you guys are interested, you can contact Rotomaster and get pricing from them. And it is really variable depending on what they're going to do for you. Like if my turbos were in worse shape, I'm sure it would be more expensive. It just all depends. So that's why I don't like giving out pricing, because I could say one thing and then somebody goes to them and it could be a totally different thing. So that's why. So that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Hopefully that'll calm down some of the haters. You know, a lot of people have been saying that I gave up on the project. It was too much for me, blah, 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 blah. That couldn't be further from the truth. I honestly haven't touched the car at all since March, since you saw it in that video at the beginning. So that's about it. I do need to have the heads sent out to get service, so I'm going to try to do that probably right after Christmas, and then hopefully get started back on this project in January. So if I don't see you guys before then, I hope you guys have a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy New Year. Stay safe out there, and spend time with your families. That's the most important thing. So we'll see you guys next year.